Name of scordas. Usipoenda nasi Bwana, hatutaweza. Ndiposa tunakualika Roho Mtakatifu uende nasi.
Kwambie, shika tangu, kwambie. Ningetaka tuombe ili tuweze kumkaribisha ndugu yetu katika jina la Yesu. Bwana, tunakushukuru kwa sababu wewe ni mwaminifu na hakuna Mungu mwingine kama wewe. Siku hii ya leo tunapoendelea kusikia neno lako, naomba kwamba ukaweze kumuinua mtumishi wako atakapofika katika madhabahu haya kunena neno lako, umbariki ili akaweze kutuletea ujumbe wako kupitia neno la Roho wako Mtakatifu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Asante kwa sababu wewe ni mwema, katika jina la Yesu Kristo mkombozi wetu tunaomba na kuamini. Amen. Karibu sana.
Naam, mtazamaji mpendwa, ni wakati mwingine siku ya leo nimekuja kukuletea neno la Mungu. Kwa majina ni Joseph Kariuki. Kristo ameniokoa, amenilinda, amenihifadhi katika upendo wake. Nimekuja nikuletea neno la Mungu na ujumbe wa neno siku ya leo ni I appeal my case. In other words, I take my case to the court of appeal. Ama issue zangu ama matakwa yangu nairudisha katika mahakama ya rufaa. Mtazamaji wangu, ni wakati mwingi adui huwa anatusukuma mpaka mahali ya kwamba tunaona ni kana kwamba mambo ambayo tuko nayo ni kama ndio ambayo tunafaa kuwa nayo na tunatosheka katika ile hali. Today I am bringing you this message to understand that it is your charge to denounce and say that I will not continue being that, like the way the enemy decides you to live, and take any charge or any issue to the high court, rather to the court of appeal, and then the Lord will judge you to your favor in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Wherever you are watching me from, if it is whichever platform, whether it is on your YouTube, whether it is on your Facebook, whether it is on whichever platform, this message is yours. And I would like you to receive it by a way of just saying amen. Commenting there, amen, because this message is yours today in the name of Jesus Christ. That whichever the issue that the enemy has decided otherwise on your side, this day we are bringing it to the court of appeal and acknowledging to the Lord that we are going to be decided, it is going to be decided on our favor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am going to mention some few facts about the court of appeal. Then you will enter to the scriptures and you will be able to understand on how the Lord will become judge on our today's case, and he is going to rule it in our favor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. One fact of the court of appeal is that the court of appeal do not deal with fresh cases. It deals with cases that have been decided elsewhere. And now, today I bring this issue to you, that however or whichever the devil has decided your case, whichever the cases that have been decided in, today we are bringing it back and it is going to be decided in your favor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The second fact of the court of appeal is that It is the second most highest court in our court systems in Kenya. And now, as I bring this issue to you, it is to understand that this issue, you are not taking it, rather we are not taking it to just a lower court, but it is a court which is very high in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. There is another fact that says that in the Federal Court of Appeal, that the minimum judges that should be deciding any case in the Court of Appeal should be 3 in numbers. And now the head of the Court of Appeal is called the President of the Court of Appeal. Praise the name of the Lord. And now, in this time, we are going to see on how our Lord is going to become the judge, the highest judge in this court, and on how the Son of God, who is Jesus Christ, is going to become the second judge, and how that judge will be the Holy Spirit of the Lord as per the scriptures. And we are going to be receiving this will in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The last one, which is the fact in the Court of Appeal, is that you must not have a lawyer for you to present your case in the Court of Appeal. And this time, sometimes you find that some issues are decided the way they are on your side, and you feel that because you have got no power to go and seek for a lawyer, you will not be able to take your issue to the Court of Appeal. This time I am letting you know through the scriptures that however your case is, you've got the Holy Spirit as the chief lawyer, and you'll be able to take your case as God is going to revise it, and it will be decided in your case in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you believe this, say amen and comment amen there, and it will be in your portion in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're going to see in scriptures, and our core scripture in our today's message will be from the book of Isaiah, chapter number 33 and verse number 22. Isaiah 33 verse number 22. It says the following, that the Lord is our judge, the Lord is our lawgiver, the Lord is our king, he is who will help us. Praise the name of the Lord. Isaiah says this, that the Lord God, the Almighty God, he is our judge, he is our lawgiver, or rather our lawyer, he is our king. And he believes, and I want you to believe with me, that as we take our issues back to the Court of Appeal, that the Lord God will help us. He is going to assist us on winning these particular cases in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because he says that he is our lawgiver, he is our king, he is our judge, and he is the one who is going to help us to make it well in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Another scripture says in the book of Romans, chapter number 8 and verse number 16, Paul states very well that the Spirit himself bears the witness with our spirit that we are God's children. That is the Spirit of the Lord. It bears the witness of our spirits that we are the children of God. So we've got the Holy Spirit of the Lord who is becoming our witness in this particular matter. We've got our God who is becoming our judge. We've got the Christ who is becoming our lawyer. So we've got nothing to fear as we enter in this particular matter. My brother, my sister, wherever you are listening to this particular scripture. It's your turn to say that I will not continue to be tormented by the devil. I am taking back my issue to the Lord. I am asking God to intervene and let my issue be decided otherwise in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And let my issue be decided in my favor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you receive this, say amen and receive it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to read scriptures in the book of 2 Kings, chapter number 20, and supposed to be from verse 1 and verse number 3, and verse number 7. 2 Kings, chapter number 20, verse number 1 and verse number 7, up to verse number 7. The Bible says this, that in those days was Hezekiah sick unto death, and the prophet Isaiah the son of Amos came to him, and said unto him, thus says the Lord, set thine house in order, for you shall die and not live. Underline that you shall die but not live. Verse number 2, then he turned his face to the wall and prayed unto the Lord, saying, I beseech thee, O Lord, remember now how I have walked before thee in truth, and with a perfect heart I have done that which is good in thy aside and Hezekiah wept Saul. I'll just rush up to number 6 and number 7. The Bible says that after I will add unto thy days 15 years, and I will deliver thee and this city out of the hand of the king of Assyria, and I will defend thee, I will defend this city for my own sake and for my servant David's sake. First number 7, it says that, and Isaiah said, take a lamb of figs, and they took and laid it on the boil, and he recovered. This was Isaiah. He received a message from God himself. It came through a prophet. It was Hezekiah. It was Hezekiah, and he received the message from the Lord, and it was said to him that put your house in order, for you shall no longer live, you will die. But as I have told you, that my theme of the message today is that I am going to appeal, or rather I appeal my case. Hezekiah decided that he's not going to leave it so and accept and let it go. He decided that I am going to let my case back to the appeal. He decided to call upon the name of the Lord. As you hear this message this morning, whichever the reports that the enemy, whichever the side that your report has been coming from, telling you that you are sick, telling you that you cannot make it, telling you that your marriage will remain in tatters, telling you that you will remain, jobless, telling you that you cannot make it, your businesses cannot make it. It is your time now. It is your turn to take a time, to take a chance and say that you are not going to let it go and move on. Say that you are going to say like Hezekiah, who decided to take his case in appeal, who decided that, remembering that the Lord that he has been serving, he can rescue him. He decided that he's gonna get back to the world and call upon the Lord and remind him what he has been faithful upon him. And at the end of the day, God remembered him. My brother, my sister, whichever the reports that you have been hearing, whichever the reports that have been coming to you, it is your time to say that I am not going to accept them. I am not going to say just the way they are to accept them. I am going to turn back. I am going to rescue myself by the word of the Lord. I am going to go back to the court of appeal. I am going to call my God Jehovah, my judge. I am going to call the Lord my Jehovah, my lawyer. I am going to call the Holy Spirit the witness. And once you take this case back to the Lord, he is going to hear you, and he is going to set the story otherwise to your favor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to read another scripture in the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel chapter number 17, and see how this brother David, how he decided that he's not going to accept the way they are. However, the enemies had decided that they are going to belittle the armies of Israel, however they had decided that this small, this particular, people will remain being belittled, will remain being defeated. He said that I am not going to accept this. And as we see in the book of 1 Samuel, chapter number 17 and verse number 28, as we read that particular verse, the Bible says that when Eliab, David's oldest brother, had him speaking with the men, he burned with anger at him and asked, why have you come down here? And with whom did you have those few sheep in the wilderness? I know how conceited you are and how wicked your heart is. You come down only to watch the battle. Praise the name of the Lord. This is the brother to Daniel, and he was the oldest. We understand there are other three brothers. That is Shama and the other Abinadab. Now this eldest one, Eliab, when this particular young man, who was David, he came from the house, and he was sent by his father to go take food to these brothers as they were struggling with the battle. And now he heard how King Saul was trying to belittle, how he was defiling the armies of Israel. And he said, and on the process, as he was trying that he's gonna face him, now the eldest brother by the name Eliab, started now belittling him. Started now, started chasing words over him and telling him that you have a wicked heart. And I remember the Lord God spoke somewhere else and told David that you've got my heart within you, that you have got my heart. And now this Eliab is telling him that you've got a wicked heart. He's saying that I'm not going to accept this, my brother, my sister. Not all the ones here should be imposed on you that you should accept. You should say that you are a son of God. You should remember that you have been called with a purpose. And now another way that he said to him is that he told him that we know how you are conceited. You know how you are wicked. How you are just anxious of knowing things that do not, you know, bother you. You are coming here to look what we are doing. You are coming here with your wicked heart. And finally he told him that you have come to watch us as we battle. Hallelujah. As this man listened, he refused to be somebody who comes just to watch. He refused to have a heart which is wicked. He said that I am going to face this man. However, you know, ready he is. However, whichever weapons that he has, I'm gonna face him in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And now, my brother, my sister, many are the times that you are belittled. Many are the times that you've got an issue ahead of you, then the enemy tells you that you cannot make it. Many are the times that you've got an issue that becomes a barrier towards reaching your destiny. And then in sometimes because of fear, because of, you know, belittling yourself, because of forgetting that you've got your judge near you, because of forgetting that it's the Lord that you have called you, you end up by letting it go. I have come to tell you, my brother, you've got all the powers, you've got all the energy, you've got all what it takes to say that I am not going to accept, I am going to take my case back to the appeal, and because my God is the king, because my God is the lawyer, because my God, he is my witness and the Holy Spirit, I am going to win it in the name of the Lord Jesus. I am going to give some few evidences for you believer, for you listener, or rather who is watching me, who is under my the influence of my voice, wherever you are, I am giving you some few evidences, because you know very well, as you enter in any case, as you enter in any court, you have to have some witnesses, you have to have some, you know, lawyers, you have to have some evidences of whichever thing that you're presenting, I am bringing you some few evidences as you enter in this particular case. And I am promising you, if you believe in yourself, if you believe in the Lord, if you believe in the chief judge who is the Lord God, hallelujah, you are going to win the case. And at the end of the day, the battle will be won by none other than by you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. As we see from this scripture, the first evidence, as I sum up, it is in the book of that particular scripture, 1 Samuel chapter number 17, verse number 33. When King Saul replied to this young man, David, he said that Saul replied, "You are not able to go out against this Philistine and fight him. You are only a young man, and he has been a warrior from this youth." My first issue here, or rather my first evidence, is that you should find a divine promise in your discouragement. Whichever discouragement that people do discourage you with, just find which is divine promise within that particular discouragement, then you will be able to walk with it and you will be able to be. This time, King Saul told David that you are just a young man. You do not have experience in war. You cannot be able to fight this Philistine. He has been in war several. He has been all along since his youth in this particular warrior. Now, how can you be able to fight him? Then, I remember this young man remembered a promise that was written, that is written in verse number 47. Because he said this, "All those who gathered here will know that it is not by sword or spear that the Lord saves, for the battle is Lord's, and he will give all of you into our hands." So you can see there is a promise there that the battle is not by spear, the battle is not by sword, neither is it by any weapon, but the battle is Lord's. And he went with this particular promise. However discouraged he was told that he was a young. He was told that he cannot make it. He was told that he did not have any experience. He remembers that the Lord is the one who gives victory. You can remember also when someone discourages you and tells you that you cannot make it. Probably he might tell you, probably you are a youth, you are not married, you cannot get anyone to marry you. They tell you that you are not beautiful. You can remember the promise that is there declared in the book of Psalms 109, that we are fearfully and wonderfully made, and then you will be able to win the battle. The Bible tells us in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter number 10, verse number 4. Paul notes, that is 2 Corinthians 10, verse number 4. Paul notes here that our weapons of welfare are not carnal, but might to pulling down the principalities, pulling down the strongholds. Remember, you are not fighting by your own. We are not fighting against the blood and flesh. We are not fighting against the carnal men. But our weapons are strong in pulling down these strongholds. The Lord will help us to pull them down in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us in the book of Zechariah, chapter number 4 and verse number 6, that these were the words they were spoken. And the Lord says that it is not by might, it is not by power, but by the word of the Lord. So, point number one, or the evidence number one that you should stand with is that you find a defined promise in your discouragement, then you go with it and you'll be able to win the battle. Second point, which is an evidence that you should go with, is that you keep the courage and move to the mission. You should be encouraged. You should stand with some courage. We should stand with some firmness because you are in the Lord. Verse number 32 says of this particular scripture, that David said to Saul, "Let no one lose heart on account of this Philistine. Your servant will go and fight him." You know, he's saying that your servant, he's calling him a servant to this particular king, that he's gonna go and fight this Philistine. I remember somewhere else calling this Philistine and circumcised. And now you wonder whether this young man was himself already circumcised or not, because he had courage to fight the man. He had the courage because he knew he's not through these weapons that he's wearing. It is not through anything. It is not by might, but by the power and the spirit of the Lord. So says the Lord Most High God. So believe this, that if you believe with me, you're going to take your case back and refuse and say that you're going to win. Point number three and point number four, very fast. Point number three is that use your past testimony to move on. Remember, David used the testimony when he said in verse number 37, that the Lord who rescued me from the paw of the lion and the paw of the bear will rescue me from the hand of these Philistines. You know, the past testimonies that the Lord has made you to win, use them. The Lord saved you. The Lord died on the cross because of your sins. The Lord made you to be free of sicknesses. The Lord made you free from sickness, from the wildness of the devil. So you can make it. Decide that you are going to make it. You've got the Lord who is fighting for you. The last evidence that I want to give you as you go to this particular, court of appeal, is that use the name of the Lord. David says in verse number 45, that David said to the Philistine, "You come against me with a sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defiled." Hallelujah. You know, when we go with the words of the Lord, we are going to make it. Because even Proverbs says, Solomon said in 18, verse number 16, that the name of the Lord is the strong tower where the righteous stand too, and they get, they get protected, rather they are saved. So, my brother, my sister, it is your time to accept that you are not going to let it go. You are not going to let the sicknesses defile you. You are not going to let the issues of the nature let you go, or rather let you go the way you are. It is your time to stand firm and believe in the Lord that He's going to help you to make it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is the time to accept this in Jesus' name. It is time to say that you are not going to let it go. It is your time to say that whichever the situation that is, bringing troubles in you, whichever the issue, if it's discouragement, the issues of the marriages, is this the issues of joblessness, is this the issue of being, chased away, disappointments, it is your time to say that this is not my portion, and accept your portion, that you can back to the Lord and tell Him, let Him interfere in your life and let you make it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am going to let it to finish in that particular point, and I believe you accept this as your portion, and I know it is not in vain that this word has come to you and you have accepted it the way it is. And I request you, just do a simple thing, that as you accept the message, you you say amen, you receive it and commend there, say this is my portion. And the Lord who is in heaven will hear this and he will come to bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray as we finish in Jesus' mighty name. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I worship you and I thank you this time because you've blessed us with your word and you've told us that we should not just let it go, that we should take our cases in your pain. And you are ready to fight for us and we are going to win in the name of the Lord Jesus. The enemy has got no room to let us just go astray. Help us, Lord. Help anyone who is listening, whoever is watching. I pray for him that you may bless him and let him believe in you and change his situation or her situation. However bad it is, you are there to come and help him win the battle in the name of the Lord Jesus. We pray this believing and trusting in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Amen.